Gamers of Reddit, what's your favorite example of game logic? At home, chickens can witness crimes due to the way Bethesda decided to code certain units. Also, horses, and I think cows. Don't forget literally all the wildlife in GTA V. Hey random stranger, I see you've come into my house uninvited. No problem. Here's a plot-specific bit of info. Feel free to search every room and take any items before you go. And break all of my jars. You are the Devakian, and you are the only one who can defeat Alduin and save the world. Sure, but I've got a lot of stuff to do first. It's okay, we can wait. Bad guy in a cave with a bunch of other bad guys. You sneakily shoot one in the head. They all look around for about 1 minute, then go back to what they were doing as if their friend's body isn't on the ground next to them. Huh, must have been my imagination. NPCs can throw things like spears from their hands without running out of ammo. They clearly aren't hiding more spears. Kill a boss who's using a ridiculously amazing looking sword and he drops 20 coins and a piece of leather. I killed Arthas and I got a mount. Let me just take this here item that is 4 times my size and put it in my pocket. Now let me put 10 more of them in my pocket. You have cured my wife's sickness. I am forever grateful. Please, take our only possession, this magical sword. May it serve you for the rest of your days. I'm wearing better. Wanna buy a sword? Oh god, this in The Witcher 3. Kraken Cried gives you the family sword, passed down for generations. Winter's Blade. I sold it cause I had a far better Witcher sword. I also sold Hartori's sword he made for me as a gift back to him because it was crap. In most games with loot, whenever you kill an animal they can drop the most random crap that is. You slay a bat, it drops a sword. Like, where the heck was that bat keeping the sword? Losing a fight? Better eat some cheese wheels to instantly heal yourself. If that fails, just freeze time again and drink 20 potions at once. I like to imagine how this would look in real life. Victorious but with cheese crumbs on your armor and hundreds of broken potion bottles at your feet. I've said this before, but you can be one of the most wanted criminals in the city, pursued by police helicopters, the game version of the FBI, and cops ready to shoot you on sight. But if you duck into a dark alley and wait a few minutes, they'll lose interest and break off their pursuit. You'll be able to drive an obviously bullet-riddled, smashed-up car right in front of cops who were chasing you minutes before, and they won't give a crap. Don't forget about the military jeeps. Quest mobs not dropping vital organs for a quest. Yes, that raptor that just fought me had no head. Makes perfect sense. I always imagined the head was just too damaged from the fight so you couldn't take it. That guy managed to shoot you in the head 6 times before you beat him to death with a pipe wrench. And if you manage to get some injuries like broken bones, just sleep it off. It'll be gone in the morning, or even an hour. Break both legs. Enough time after walking it's all cured. Break head, torso, and left leg. Shove stimpak in arm. All injuries cured. Fallout is really weird about that. You never talk and everyone praises you and gives you free stuff. You routinely take down cult-like criminal organizations at the age of 10. If only the real world worked this way. Pokemon. Stomp on a car and blow it to Kingdom Freak. Go ahead and wave your RPG around a police officer, but touch his bumper, you've just become the next Ted Bundy. You murdered 30 people and the police are chasing you. Just put on new shoes, that'll throw them off the trail. But don't worry, the hot dog man who just saw you blow their heads to red mist will always sell you food that will heal your bullet holes. Shot, incinerated or blown to bits by a tank, you'll be all patched up and ready to go at your local hospital within a day. Speaking of which, a hospital visit costs $100. What is this, Denmark? If it was Denmark, it would be free, and you'd get free psych help afterwards. Source, I live there. I don't know why this sticks out to me so much, but when locked doors have hinges that swing both ways. Also, how every important code or clue is kept in a book somewhere. Missing a clue? Well, it's a good thing the person keeps a detailed journal open on their desk. I could probably hack, login, to about 1/3 of my co-workers' computers just by lifting up their keyboard and getting their password off that post-it note. You can take any old stick and any old rock, and if you combine the two, your character just pulls some rope and a sharpening surface out of their butthole and builds a spear hatchet. Using only a squirrel, a piece of string, and a megaphone, Dave ingeniously fashioned a homemade megaphone. Oh no, your colleague's about to collapse from being shot in the chest. What do you do? Why, shoot him in the foot and revive him. Ah, good as new. Thanks, Tom Clancy. They have 5 of the best terrorists in the world inside that building. Better only send 5 counter-terrorists with no backup to help them. Oh, great tidings. The prophecy has come true. The hero has arrived to save us from Armageddon. Let us know if there's anything you need. How about that sweet legendary sword of 1000 truths you've got in the display case there? Oh sure, that'll be 100k gold pieces. Oh, it only looks like you have a handful of copper pieces. Yeah, but I need it to save the world. Sir, if you aren't going to buy something, I'm going to have to ask you to leave. Can I at least use the restroom first? Sorry, paying customers only. Oh, you saved us and catered to our useless needs every time you come to town? You're still an outsider. I'll keep my eye on you. Holding 299/300 lbs and stuff. Run at breakneck speeds forever. Pick up a pencil and you're reduced to crawling to make it to the door. RPG dialogue trees would sound bizarre in real life. Yeah, so I'm a novelist. Tell me more about novels. They, are books. You've read a book before, right? Tell me more about reading. It's whenever you translate symbols on a page into sounds and words. Tell me more about symbols. Are you? Goodbye. Proceeds to stand still for 18 hours and then restarts the conversation. In Skyrim, I can turn a bandit's face into a quiver and he'll still be charging at me saying you never should have come here. It takes 1 to 2 bullets to kill player character who is just regular human. All other non-playable regular humans require at least 6 times that amount. You take about 10,000 bullets throughout the course of the game, and heal within seconds. Then at the end of the game you're shot with a pistol, a cinematic, and you're on the brink of death. That flower adds 0.5 weight. That mushroom 0.5 weight. 78,000 gold pieces weigh nothing. Don't forget about the 1000 arrows that also weigh nothing. Euro Truck Simulator 2. Exceed the speed limit near a speed camera and you get a 550 euro fine. Where's the game logic in here? Well, driving on the wrong side of the road would give you a 100 euro fine. And that's only if you stay on the wrong side for too long, and hitting a vehicle is 400 euros. Meaning going 95 on a road limited to 90 kilometers per hour will cost you more than ramming a car head on with your truck on the highway. Truck repairs notwithstanding. Yep. Doomguy's weapon and ammo inventory. In SSB, you punch a guy to the left, they fly right. MMORPGs. On female characters, less armor means more protection. Gao, after getting shot 100 times, you can hide undercover and be ready to go at it again in a few seconds. MGS, after escaping from alert stage, the guards go back to their normal patrols like nothing happened. Elder Scrolls, my sneak is at 100, so I can crouch in front of someone and be hidden. And because my pickpocket is also at 100, I can steal all of their clothes without them noticing. My favorite is the plate armor that randomly cuts off mid-tit or thigh. It's like they started putting on their armor but forgot to finish getting dressed. I can't aim down my sights. I get stopped in my tracks when someone throws a 400-gram metal cylinder at me. I can jump around at speeds faster than Usain Bolt. And my country doesn't give me much money to fight off losing efforts against terrorism. I love Counter-Strike. Best I can think of right now would be the GTA V cops. If you stand in front of them for too long or even have done a minor crime, you will be killed for it. Any and all invisible goddamn walls. I can see the next objective right below me, so I'll just jump off this platform over to that outcropping and jump back over to it. Nope, frick you. That outcropping you can see is just scenery and you'll hit it and bounce off and fall to your death, frick you, every game. Ejecting from your jet to a platform. Kill a man with your defibrillator. Jump from the platform on your plane which is falling. Enter it and fly away. In most games, once I'm fairly certain about which way I'm supposed to be going in order to progress a game, I immediately go every other way first to make sure I'm not missing some dank loot. In Skyrim, NPCs have unlimited arrows. If you shoot them with a better arrow than what they have, they'll now have an unlimited supply of that arrow, and will shoot you with it because it's technically in their inventory. I'm Batman. I can do anything, except cross police tape, or go down broken stairs. I'm an adventurer. I have amazing abilities and I can climb any surface, but I can't get over this knee-high cliff face, or rock wall, or fence. It's the end of the game. I am almost a god at this point. The enemies I couldn't easily kill at the beginning of the game are back, and now I'm OP. This will be fun. Oh wait, for some reason they're all stronger now too, and they killed me. I guess I wasn't the only one training. The Sims. Meet a girl at 1 o'clock. Start dating her at 2 o'clock. Move in together at 3 o'clock. Get married 4 o'clock. Knock her up at 5 o'clock. In vanilla World of Warcraft, I remember you couldn't fly to another destination point unless you discovered it, which means you have to walk there on foot first. That's like saying I have to walk to Phoenix's airport first before I can fly there in the future. I can kill dragons and giants within a few seconds, but I am not able to break an ancient wooden door because there is a wooden bolt on the other side. You can have pistols holstered, a giant assault rifle, and an RPG on your back, but still not be considered suspicious by the police military. The way HP functions in basically every game ever, which is you're fine until you reach zero, then you're instantly dead. If you had been beating shot etc. to within any realistic equivalent of 1 HP, you barely function and probably not survive anyway. I'm a chick, so I must dress in next to nothing, but be just as protected as the fully covered dudes in the game. Also, jiggle physics or GTFO. There is a character in Skyrim who just goes around making sure all of the torches are lit in all of the caves and dungeons. The bandits and Dwemer machines leave him alone because he's just Yanni, the torch lighting guy. He has a free pass behind all the locked doors, because it's his eternal job to make sure everything is well lit. Playing the Elder Scrolls and carrying two sets of heavy armor and seven weapons, grabbing a quill pen makes it so you can't no longer walk. That final Mass Effect battle. Gather the biggest fleet in history, jump into your home system and have the fleet face Earth and tell them to all fire at once. Dear God, the amount of destruction from that single volley. Looks like nobody paid much attention to the drill sergeant from ME2. Right so, League of Legends, book and wand? Well, that makes a staff semi-reasonable, I guess. Book and other book? That makes a stronger book. Good, what about two of the same book? Well, that makes a revolver. And if you add a wand to that gun, what do you get? That's right, ammo the book. I love that all the merchants in the world always sell at the exact same price, and nobody will sell you a mithril sword until you're in the area with the cave where you need it. 5 minutes ago in Metro, I looted a corpse that a librarian was eating without it noticing. Fine with me, it's easier than fighting it. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.